Welcome to There Going, the Alternative Culture Review.
Is that your question?
No, it's 4, 5, 6.
How can we really verify that your orientation is valid?
No, you can't.
There's no way.
Been to meetings where there might be the odd hunter, a shark seeker, starting off with those tracking, exploratory questions, searching for clarifications, seeking a common language with Tony before they shoot, seeming to think they can undermine the message. Then there might be a bit of confusion, the questions might get a bit wilder or more direct, until, well, the questioner gives up or has to accept others want to ask questions too. There's a limit to the time in the meeting after all.
People reacting aggressive, or that they wouldn't want to listen. So that's happening to me too. And you would just stop talking. And this is what making people much more aggressive.
Yes. Absolutely. And it creates, apparently this message creates suffering in people too.
Yeah.
There isn't anything here that reacts. There isn't anything here. What you're saying is that we all have different experiences, therefore there must be some relevance.
Yeah.
But the different experiences are what's happening in the story, and the story is illusory and has no relevance of any kind. It's only the me that believes that its story is very important and significant because it's going somewhere else. There isn't anything going anywhere, there's only what is, and what is the timeless.
This non-dual message is that one thing isn't better than another, that it just isn't the case that one thing has relevance and another doesn't, or one thing has more relevance than another. In fact, that all phenomena is illusory, it isn't real, just as a dream isn't real. Thank you.
possibly with the idea of getting something, but this is the place to meet your perfect lover. This is where you meet, you can meet the perfect lover, the one that never left you, the one that will never leave you, regardless of what you do, or how you think you are. Watches you as you go round looking for perfection. And the perfect lover has watched you build churches and build religions and build empires, none of which have any meaning. And the perfect lover sees you going to learn about enlightenment. So you go as a seeker and you go to a teacher who is also a seeker, who also teaches seeking.
Makes it a lot easier. I just take the little girl and I'm not here.
And the perfect lover watches as you go off and try to become worthy. The perfect lover watches you in your room meditating and trying to still the mind, which is an utter ridiculous impossibility. The perfect lover watches you as you sing mantras and clear chakras and forgive your mother, maybe. All the time, the perfect lover watches you as you try to become whole or acceptable or worthy of the perfect lover. But the perfect lover doesn't need you to become anything, because already the perfect lover totally and utterly accepts you as you are. Absolutely as you are, with all those things that you think might be wrong. With an unstill mind, with a huge ego, it's great. Because the perfect lover is all it is. The perfect lover is you looking for these things, is the seeker looking, searching for that which seems to be lost. What is lost has never left you. What is lost has never given up on you. What is lost seems to have been lost, has always held you there, watched you, looking for it. And what we actually look for is absence. What the seeker is looking for, although the seeker doesn't know it, and doesn't want to know it, is the absence of seeking.
I see angels. Angels in this very room. Now, I may be mad, but that doesn't mean that I'm not right. Because there's another force at work here. There always has been. It's undeniable. We've all experienced it. Everyone in this room has witnessed events that they can't fathom, let alone explain away by rational means. Puzzles deciphered in prophecy. Dreams given to a chosen few. Our loved ones dead. Risen. Whether we want to call that God or gods or some sublime inspiration or a divine force that we can't know or understand, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It's here. It exists. And our two destinies are entwined in its force.
Whatever we try to do to reach this point, we still are invested in the idea that we are a person who can do something, and that is the ignorance. There is no one sitting in this room. There is no individual sitting in this room. All that's sitting in this room is aliveness. All that's in this room is being. Being is all there is.
If that were true, that's a big if. How do I know this force has our best interests in mind? How do you know that God is on your side, Doctor?
I don't. God's not on any one side. God's a force of nature, beyond good and evil. Good and evil, we created those. You want to break the cycle? Break the cycle of birth, death, rebirth, destruction, escape, death. And that's in our hands. In our hands only. Requires a leap of faith. Requires that we live in hope, not fear.
All there is experiences, sensations happening. And they're happening to no one, they're just sensations. Including thinking. Nobody in this room has ever had a thought of their own.